Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and right now I'm not in a happy mood in saying my intro because right now today it's a serious video, so and just by the title you can see that it is about bullying that we should stop it. No, and if you are experienced bullying, you should actually tell someone. Like, don't be afraid to ask for help because it's a very big, serious thing because it can lead to something bad. So, today I have people's opinions. I've asked them through stories and they replied to me. I told them to share their experience and tell me what it is. And this video, this is a big project that is here just to help people around the world to stop bullying. So it is hashtag people bullying, we can stop it. That's the hashtag. So just share this to your friends who are experienced bullying. Tell them that they're not alone and they should actually go and tell the teacher. So I have this list of people's names and all of their Instagrams are all in the description below. So go follow them too. So let's get started. First, it is Avrille Gerosano. She is my classmate. This is what hers. I'm reading it on what she said. She said that this is for everyone. If you have a problem with someone, go tell them and work it out. If you're not holding grudges against a person, let it go. You see, talking behind people's backs isn't the solution. And believing to what they're saying, come on, that's not gonna do it. Him or her, and you start making rumors, is that going to make her be jealous of stuff? Ask yourself. Ever wonder why someone literally stops talking to you? Don't wonder, because you already know that someone has said something to him or her about you. Just laugh it out. Laugh because they want to get the rumors. If you have done so much for that person and they don't see all the effort, then stop, because you're just missing out on your sweat on someone who doesn't deserve it. Or doesn't even care. It's not fair anymore. She experienced those kinds of things, and there are so many things that I realized, and one of them is she quit. She quit letting people who have proven that they don't really care about her. Guys, never dim your light, make it shine. And to those who have been hearing rumors about other people, don't believe them unless you have the right proof, alright? Or talk to them personally to bring down the border that has been separating you. And also to everyone who has encountered these things, I applaud you because you're getting stronger and stronger. Never let someone stop bring you down. Y'all should stop living up to someone's expectations. Wait for the right person to come. Love who you are. By Avrille Gerosano. Thank you, A, for this inspirational message you just sent. Sure, okay. A. Next is Krisa. And she has a YouTube channel too. I have no idea what's her Instagram, but her YouTube channel is Krisa the Queen. Right here is her channel. And I'll also put it in the description box below. She said, there are a lot of reasons for a person to bully. It may be because of their jealousy or maybe just for fun. But I think the most important reasons are lack of attention and aggression. Bullying is a way of a person to get attention due to the lack of attention from friends, family, and general. Not only it can be due to lack of attention, but also from depression. They bully others so that they may feel the same pain that they are feeling. But that doesn't mean they are allowed to do it. Hurting another people's feelings is not gonna solve your problems. Instead, freedom of speech and communication are simple but effective ways to solve problems, because of solving problems and complex needed opinions and each side's point of view. Without these solving problems and conflicts will be solved and may cause great bad effect to them and cause them to release their troubles by bullying. This is very true that bullying can make it look like you're not really bullying, but they just want you to feel the same way that they're experiencing. But they don't know that you're also experiencing that, but just in a different way. That's why you shouldn't bully. This opinion is by Rovalyn. She has a YouTube channel too. Her name is WazupRova. Here is her channel here, and I'll put link to it in the description box below. Her Instagram is at Rovalyn Sunga, so go follow her. She said, bullying has eight letters in a word. A word that is understandable by its word, because this word is very known to everyone. And this is been done to people who are insecurity and jealous about other people's lives. Many people have lost their lives, their future, their value. In this case, we have to limit ourselves and avoid bullying, because we are the ones who are making this all. And she said thanks. So thank you, Rovalyn, for that inspirational message. So yeah, bullying has eight letters, and just by the word bullying, it obviously means that you're being bullied by someone constantly, and they have no idea that they're actually hurting you, but they do sometimes. Next one is by AK Generoso. She is my friend, and she her Instagram is at AK at Crispy. In Instagram, it's in the description box below, just in case I said that wrong. And her speech is very long and hard for me to speak it, so I'm also going to put the text here so that you can see what I'm reading, because I don't read these kind of big words, but she's in college. So she said, bullying is one of the endemic, dilemmatic that is rampant in any place. May it be in school, workplaces, and hospitals. This is the issue of power, authority, and governance. Bullying is dangerous, true. It does not only hurt the victim physically, but it leads to further damage, like causing the victim emotional distress such as depression, anxiety, panic, and possibly suicide. Bullying is not through actions, but also verbal. Calling names, judging, and limiting one's capacity is already bullying. With all these situations regarding bullying, there should be a proper education, not just for professionals, but even those of the younger years. I am a victim of bullying. She is a victim of bullying before, because she was fat. She was called Bubboy. It was really disturbing to her and lead her to have decreased self-esteem. But by His grace, I recovered and realized that I was made for a purpose, that I was by in His own image and likeness. Today, as His democratic is still existing, there should be lessons on bullying that the students should be aware of. That's why I am making this video, by the way. Moreover, bullying should be taken seriously, especially by those in position. The perpetrators or the bullies should be called attention to and should be told of the possible effects it could have on the victim. There should be awareness for this program, that many will change and be given the chance to change. And for those bullied, that they will stand their right and know that all of the harmful words and actions done to them are not true, but rather believe that they are beautiful and they are loved by the Creator who made them. So in summary of what she just said, that bullying, there are many ways of bullying, and that sometimes the bully doesn't quite know that they're bullying unless it's already become too much. But the victim or the student who's getting involved in this, you should actually stand up and talk to the teacher, or talk to them and tell them that what they're doing is wrong. Don't be holding them back. They can't hurt you once you tell on them, because something bad will happen to them if you will tell them. Next one is Monique Cabilin. Her speech is very short, but she did it in a way that is very understandable. She said, "We believe that we are made in His image and likeness, and Jesus is in each and one of us. Bullying and degrading someone for their looks, race, and clothes is like a bully and degrading God our Father. So do you think degrading your Creator and Father is good? Well, it's all up to you. It may be short, but there's a powerful meaning that's being said in all of these. Including the shortest ones, there are also often less meaning. Because you're bullying someone who is also like your brother or your sister, just not by blood, but being made by the same Creator who made us all. You should be thankful." This is from my friend Nicole Baberia, and it's also in Filipino, so I will try my best to read this as much as I can, but I will put subtitles in this so that's easier for you guys to understand. Bullying is a form of hurting people. It will affect the person being bullied, like mata, paint job, or things that are not in the app, or for a dealing mind, or a mata, or child bullying. Also, main example on that is suicide. Mas ganahan yung case of suicide about sa bullying. So if ako ay bully, ako din na bully someone na older pa ako. Para magkabantay ko na ng someone kahit pwede na ako parents or teachers pwede jud sa guidance para mag-stop jud siya para ako mag-ignas tao further damage o malakita ko kung na ayaw ipuli kaya una man jud anang mahuna gunaan kay tabandan ni mo or ipitan ni mo pero sa panghuna-huna sa imong sigi na po yun ang percentage na i-risk ni mo ang imong self para mataban tabahan ang isang katao so ang pwede ang buhaton ana si tabandan ni mo ang tao pero dili kahit ikaw sa ang makatumbuhang sangot na kahit teens patas so kita ang gusto ko kinatahan magpun o tabang para masolve siya na problem. It may be Filipino guys but I can also understand some Filipino so I get what she's saying here. She's saying that you should tell someone, like a teacher or someone who's older than you, so that they can help you when you will be confronting the person. Not just yourself, because what if they're bigger and you're like smaller than them? Not meaning short, meaning like you're like they're stronger than you, and they can just hurt you too if you're just by yourself without anyone with you. So you should actually tell someone, so like someone will help you. You can't just fight bullying alone. Guys, this is a long video, so but if you care enough, watch the whole thing if you actually care about bullying and if you're one of the victims. This one is by my friend Leslie. Statement, she said, bullying is when you tease another person. There are many kinds of bullying, but it can also cause depression. This is one of the many, many reasons of why people are sad lately also. So you shouldn't fight by yourself. You should actually tell a person so that they can help you. Because if this just goes on every single day, it can also make you feel like you're like in a prison. Like you can't get out. You're just trapped. The person is like trying to make you do whatever you want. They want. And not what you want. Alright, you have the freedom, right? You are free to do good things. True faith for God, you should actually tell the person, no matter if they are also bullied, you should also tell them what they're doing is wrong. Because it can lead to bad damage too. So guys, I'm back again and it's getting there, so I'm gonna do this really kind of quick. So the next one is has experienced this, and all ended in a sad way. And it's, you know, the way that you're supposed to, like, you know, I don't like to say it much because it's already too late to say much about it. Yeah, so bullying is very serious, guys. The next one is by Joanna Marie. Everyone has a bully, and that's something we have to have in life to make us individuals stronger, no matter what our age is. I've been bullied by a boy, and I didn't like it. No one does. He would bully her, make other bullies along with him, but then they just stopped because I didn't show them that it didn't care for me anymore. And I know the reason why, because they saw I didn't have an affection to their action, and I know this because I'm a bully myself. We are always some bullies. That's true, we are bullies once in a while, but you should know your limits, because it is not good if you constantly hurt someone. Because if you like push someone like almost every day, then it kind of gets annoying, and then they'll tell you to stop, but you wouldn't stop, so then it's already said as bullying, even if it's your friend that you're doing that to. Next one is by Jaxelle. Said bullying is a crime. Today, a lot of children are facing this problem in schools, and I'm one of them. It's a vicious assault on the mind, body, and spirit. It can destroy relationships and wreck families' lives. It opens a box of physiological phenomena, anxiety, panic attacks, nightmares, loss of hope, and suicide itself. Bullying must stop. And if you can see cyberbullying happening to someone else, you can stop it by not engaging or forwarding anything, and by telling the bully to stop. Bullying must be stopped. So think before you speak, so you cannot hurt anything. This whole speech, every word that she said in this action video, because like many people are facing it today, and there is like lots of effects that this can happen, like even like anxiety or panic attacks, nightmares. You get nightmares of this bully hurting you. So it's like not just safe when the bully is with you, but also in your dreams. And you're gonna lose hope because you're afraid the dream is gonna be wrecked by the bully. Last and final one is by Kez Gerosano, sister of Avrille Gerosano. She said, personally, bullying in my own definition is basically making fun of others, whether it is physically or emotionally. For the bully, it might be fun, but for the victim, it isn't. Bullying affects a person both physically and emotionally. However, based on experience, it affects more on the physical-logical side. It affects a personal confidence level, attitude towards things, and even makes them question their worth or existence. Bullying must be taken seriously because it can also affect a child's ability to learn in school. Therefore, change lives, be a voice, and stop bullying. There is a reason, guys, I'm making this video. Laugh at this video because I'm making it. I'm not embarrassing myself by making all of these videos. I do these videos to entertain you, except this video right now. I'm telling you now. This big project is just to tell everyone around the world that we should all stand in together and help one another to stop bullying once and for all. That's why this video titled hashtag We Can Stop It, Bullying We Can Stop It. All of you guys, you guys should know the definition of bullying. You just think like, oh, I can just push you around just because like, oh, they're your friend. But if you constantly do that every single day, try and ask the person how they feel. They don't tell you the truth because sometimes they know that if they tell you the truth, you might think that they're just lying or they're too afraid to tell you that. Try and ask the person without like angering them. Just tell them, like, did I hurt you? Ask them, because they would answer it. But if you say it in anger, obviously they won't tell you. Be a person who is good. We are all bad sometimes, but we don't have to keep doing it every single day. Try and ask other people. Some already are in heaven and we can't stop them because they already made it there. We can still stop it and we still have the chance to do that. So I want all of you guys to please, you can like this video if you agree that bullying should stop. And share this, guys, to your friends. Tell them what I'm telling you guys, what's the message of this video. Share it to Facebook, Instagram, any other places like on social media. It's okay if you don't want to subscribe to this channel, but subscribe so that you can see other videos, because I'm still going to be uploading about bullying and about, you know, everything else about bullying that you guys need to know. So thank you guys so much for your time, and also hashtag bullying we can stop it. So guys, I'll be seeing you guys next time in my next video. So peace out.